Okay, I'm gonna try to show you how tiling shortcuts work in Plasma 5.20, but I'm really not sure what's default here, what works, what doesn't, what's bug, what's feature. Anyway, I'm just saying what I see, and let's start by opening a terminal. Super and left will do this. Super and top does that. Super and right will tile right. Super and bottom will tile bottom. And super and left, and repeat to restore. Okay, now what's new? At least what I think it's new, because you can never be sure with Plasma. Super left and up inside 1 second, will quarter tile and left top corner. Super right and top. Super bottom and right. Super bottom and left. Super left and left to restore. I believe this is actually a bug, and the animation should be executed in a single step. And now I will repeat the same process, but this time I will press both arrows at the same time. So, super and left and up at the same time. Super and right up together. Super and bottom right. Super and bottom left. Super and up left, and again to restore. The heuristics feel pretty natural really, and next I'm going to open 4 windows and quickly tile them with keyboard only for demonstration. So, 1, 2. 1, 2 moves. 1 and 2. Now I lost that, so I will use mouse after all, and 1, 2. So we now have 4 tiled windows, and we can easily move their positions with shortcuts. But if we want to be honest for a moment, this tiling is totally trash because it can only tile in 50% of the space, which is almost never the case in actual use. And Plasma still can't resize multiple windows from a single grub point, like everyone else. At least not by default. Another new thing in 5.20 is that if we open Desktop's Edit Mode, and then Panel Settings, we'll now get a spin box to easily resize the panel height. Very very useful, but there is one additional reason I'm showing it, and that's obviously the spin button's design. If we open Dolphin, a second to resize the window. And anyway, we have something new for 5.20 release here too. If we go to Settings and Previews, we can select file types individually, and then set the maximum size for previews, both for local and remote files. But do you see this super super annoying spin button? How hard can possibly be to fix normal spin buttons? GTK has them for 10 years now, without even having developers. Next let's go to Settings, and there is nothing new here but just a small UI observation. So Window Management, and Title Bar Actions Panel. Seriously? Look all these lines. Other kids count sheep to sleep, but Plasma kids count lines. And there is so much more wrong going here apart the lines. So look where this label starts, and then look where that label starts, because someone thought it was a good idea to align things in center. Then these selections are perfectly aligned between them. But this one isn't and it just looks ugly. Lesson to learn, when you don't have a design language, you can't even make combo box groups. But one positive in this panel is that if we change a value, we only have an apply button and not an OK too. Oh, and meanwhile we can make a reset without having made any changes before, because for making a change we need to apply first. This thing not only is annoying in use, but it completely lacks workflow logic. And because this channel is very serious, today we have with us a Plasma designer, to explain us why all those happen.